Hello everyone. Congenital anomalies of optics underlie many cases of decreased vision in childhood. I am Ajinkya and today I am going to glorify one of such anomaly, that is morning glory disc. In next few minutes, we will cover this topic with four objectives: to know clinical features, ocular and systemic associations of morning glory disc, and how to differentiate between morning glory disc from disc coloboma. Let's begin with the first objective. Morning glory disc was so named by Kindler because of its resemblance to morning glory flower. It is congenital funnel-shaped excavation of the posterior fundus that incorporates optic disc. It is mostly unilateral but can be bilateral. The macula may be incorporated into the excavation. Ophthalmoscopically, disc is markedly enlarged, orange or pink in color, and may appear recessed or elevated. A wide annulus of chorioretinal pigmentary disturbances surrounds the disc. A white tuft of glial tissue fills the central portion of the disc. The blood vessels appear increased in number and show radial disposition. What are the ocular associations of morning glory disc? Serous retinal detachments have been estimated to develop in 26 to 38% of eyes. These originate in peripapillary area and extend posteriorly, occasionally progressing to total retinal detachments. Spontaneous resolution of retinal detachments is possible. It can also be associated with rheumatogenous retinal detachment or peripapillary choroidal neovascular membrane. It has been shown to be associated with persistent fetal vasculature. One study by Ping et al. Reported presence of PHPV in 22 out of 85 eyes. Thus, they suggest that the regression of hyaloid vasculature is easily compromised with optic disc defects and the whitish tissue is derived from primitive hyaloid system. Other associated ocular conditions can be congenital cataract, posterior lenticonus, optic chiasm hypoplasia, optic nerve glioma, etc. Now let's see the systemic associations. The first one, transsphenoidal basal encephalocele, which is a rare midline congenital malformation and contains chiasm and adjacent hypothalamus. It protrudes through a large round defect in sphenoid bone. It can protrude into the nasopharynx and cause airway obstruction. They may have dysmorphic features like wide head, flat nose, mild hypertelorism, and presence of midline upper lip notch or cleft palate. It can also be associated with Moyamoya disease, in which there is hypoplasia of unilateral intracranial vessels. Now this is MR angiography, which shows hypoplasia of internal carotid artery. Next is face syndrome, which is exclusively seen in girls and has ipsilateral orofacial hemangiomas. The spectrum includes posterior fossa malformations, large facial hemangiomas, arterial and cardiac anomalies, and eye anomalies. Coming to the last objective, how to differentiate morning glory disc from disc coloboma? Unlike morning glory disc, coloboma is bowel-shaped white excavation involving inferior portion extending to choroid and retina. The presence of central glial tissue is characteristic of morning glory disc and is absent in coloboma. There is presence of peripapillary annular pigmentation in morning glory disc, whereas minimal pigmentary disturbance is observed in coloboma. Coloboma is associated with CHARGE syndrome, in which multidisciplinary approach is crucial. Friends, let's recapitulate the glory of today's topic. Morning glory disc is a funnel-shaped excavation involving disc, characterized by presence of central glial tissue, radial disposition of vessels, and annular pigmentation. It is associated with various ocular and systemic disorders, and one must differentiate it from disc coloboma, latter being associated with CHARGE syndrome. Friends, we learned about one of the excavatory disc anomaly today. What are different hypoplastic disc anomalies? Let's see. Thank you for your patient listening.